Welcome to Chapter 4 of this Masterclass discussion on liquidity management, brought to you by The Banker magazine. My name's Michael Imeson, I'm an editor at The Banker. I'm joined here today by Christine Goerlach, who works in cash management for financial institutions at the Global Transaction Banking Division in Deutsche Bank. We've been talking about financial regulation and how it affects liquidity management in banks. And we're now going to finish on what it is that banks can do to mitigate the effects of all this regulation. So Christian, a lot of regulation out there is having a big impact on the banks. What can the banks do about it to alleviate these impacts?
Right. So most important in my view is that we keep the dialogue open and maybe even intensify it. And what I mean is that not only the dialogue between banks and regulators, but with all involved parties, which include the banks and the regulators, but also central banks, and the clearing systems and all the other affected parties, so that we find intelligent ways to implement all these regulations which we identified make sense on their own, but we need to implement them in a way so that we avoid unintended consequences. The second thing is that every bank basically needs to adjust their risk management to the new reality. And that could mean for the things that you decide to do within your bank, you need to make sure that your processes and your setup is according to the new reality. And for the areas where you decide to partner with another bank to buy services from another bank, it's very important to ensure that you choose the right partner in these times. And when we come back to the subject of transaction banking, I think it's very important that the partner is really dedicated and committed to transaction banking, because there's a lot of investment required going forward. And when I say investment, it's not only the IT investment, but there's also a lot of IT investment if you want to comply with all the regulation and digest this in a way that is sustainable. But also, you have to invest in people that have the intellectual capacity to think these things through, not only for your bank, but also for your clients. Find the right solutions for the bank and for the client.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Christine, thank you very much. That's all we have time for. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.